time for the match game, Hollywood Squares Hour. With from another world, Steven Schnetzer. From the Jeffersons, Roxie Roker. Bruce Baum. Judy. Stars of the match game, Hollywood Squares Hour, Gene Rayburn and John Bowman.
We thank you for your enthusiasm.
The fourth over 2 days.
And it's well-founded and well-deserved, because these are all wonderful, gifted, witty, charming, amusing people. And
where?
Some of them are...
Not too big a building.
But which is which? He's wonderful, he's gifted, I'm charming.
You're right. I don't know. You figure it out yourselves. Anyone have any retorts or shots they want to take?
I saw John in Us Magazine. They had a thing with celebrity pops and their kids, which I was conspicuously left out of. But we both have year-and-a-half-old sons, a couple weeks from each other. And, you know, it's such a problem to keep them in a room. They have those gates. They end up climbing over them. You can't keep them. We've worked out something that seems to keep the kids in the room.
Barbed wire. How does it work?
I'll tell you what else this is good for. This is also good, like when you're sneaking into places late at night.
Yeah.
And so the security guard sees you, he's about a block away. You can go, hey, I'm still on the outside. Just kind of sneak up. Good for pretending you're at the Jackson 5 concert. Let me just touch Michael. It's got a lot of uses.
Yes. Listen, don't get any, I mean, don't get hurt down there with that thing. Thank you, Bruce. All right, now would you all join me in greeting our two players here, Lisa Winghartline and Ron Washam.
Yeah, you're good.
Okay. Now we're going to meet Lisa first and find out a little bit about her. Lisa?
Well, I'm originally from Baltimore, Maryland. Been out here for 2 years. I'm married, and I'm currently attending bartending school.
Really?
Yeah.
You're married to two guys, Wing and Hartline, huh?
No, one guy, just one heck of a long last name.
Right. All right, Lisa, good luck to you. Let's find out about Ron.
Well, I'm a freelance writer, and to make money, I'm a waiter.
Right.
I'm a native Californian, and my hobbies include tasting wine and collecting wine. I prefer tasting, in case anybody cares. And I also am an avid zoo goer.
Really?
Yes.
Which zoos have you been to? All of them?
Wherever I go to a city, I always look to see if they have a zoo, if I'm passing through, so I can go.
What kind of writing do you do, Ron?
I write comedy.
Okay, uh-oh. Start right now.
There we go. Okay. Yeah.
Hey, what'd you think of that barbed wire routine?
Yeah,
routine?
Well, yeah, you want to give
on a scale of 1 to 10?
1 to 10, what about the barbed wire routine?
10 being best? Yeah. Easy 8.
Well, here's an easy 8.
Here's a fun thing to do if you're ever at the zoo. I like to go to the zoo and tease the apes with Samsonite luggage. Just kind of holding on. Come on! Come on!
All right, let's start the match game. You'll have 3 chances to match as many of our stars as you can. The winner will go on to challenge the returning champion on Hollywood Squares for a chance to win up to $30,000. Lisa won the toss. She'll go first.
A, please.
All right. The world's oldest living man said... Here at the home, the doctor calls me Mr. Wrinkle. You see, everybody has wrinkles on their skin, but me, I have wrinkles on my blank. That's a good one.
She's run out of paper.
I had too many answers here. Okay.
Okay. Now we're ready for Lisa. Here we go, Lisa. The world's oldest living man said, here at the home, the doctor calls me Mr. Wrinkle. You see, everybody has wrinkles on their skin, but me, I have wrinkles on my blank.
Wrinkles.
Wrinkles on my wrinkles. All right. That's one possibility.
Yeah, that's a great one. Well, I said he would have wrinkles on his gums.
On his gums. That's a good one, one I hadn't thought of. Very good, Roxie. Bruce?
Well, I think I finally did it.
Wrinkles out of wrinkles here.
TD.
Roxie and I were thinking alike. Wrinkles on my teeth.
Teeth is a good one.
Yeah. Yeah.
Now listen, you can't boo that.
That's a very positive boo.
Because, you know, wrinkles on your teeth and hair are two almost impossible things, and that's why those are good responses. And gums, you know, all that sort of thing, where normally you would not find wrinkles. What do you say?
So glad you explained that, Jim.
Yes, that justifies your answer.
No, had this been Ron, who was a comedy writer, I would have definitely said wrinkles. I wasn't too sure about Lisa, but I said wrinkles anyway.
Two for Lisa.
Good for you. Hey, nice jacket.
Thanks. Hey, nice jacket.
Thanks.
Yeah, like it a lot. I think
today is a hyphen. Nice jacket. Okay, Steven.
John and I phoned each other last night to determine what we would be wearing today. So we
then we both called Judy and told her.
Somebody should tell this gentleman that Preparation H will shrink his wrinkles. I said wrinkles.
All right. Three for Lisa.
Left over for a previous guy.
Okay, Judy.
Wrinkles on his teeth.
Teeth is good. All right, so you picked up three there. That's very unusual and very good for a first-round question. Ron, this one is for you. Lou said, did you hear they're making a movie about my wife's housekeeping? It's called... Gee, we should have read it, got the echo chamber ready here. Well, it's too late. It's called... It Came From Beneath the Blank.
A movie about my wife's housekeeping.
A movie about my wife's housekeeping called It Came From Beneath the Blank.
You know, Gene, you could probably tell I was a little bit bummed out today.
Yes, you were. You did look a little.
Yeah, you know, my horse died about a week ago, and I really didn't have enough money to have the whole thing taxidermed, but I think I did the next best thing. I'm just going to keep him around the house.
Yes. 1 quart of Elmer's glue. All right. One horse. Steve, are you in the slot?
Oh, yeah, yes. Why
all right.
Why did you get that?
Run.
Thank you.
Lou said, did you hear they're making a movie about my wife's housekeeping? It's called It Came From Beneath the Blank.
The bed.
The bed is one. All right. It's okay. What do you got for us, Roxie?
Well, that was a wonderful location for it, but I said it came from beneath the rug.
Another good one. That's good. Hers is good. I mean, his is good, and hers is good, and yours is good, too.
Mine came from under the sofa.
Another good one. A lot of good ones here.
I tend to equate bad housekeeping with the kitchen, so I said it came from beneath the sink.
Aha, yeah. What do they call those little balls of fuzz that gather under the
fuzz
bed?
Balls.
Fuzz balls.
They're called fuzz
balls.
That's a good name for them.
Oh, yeah.
It's fun to try
who
to get your...
thought that up?
It's fun to get your cat to try to swallow one of those, too.
Oh, really?
In the throat.
No. And they eat a lot of grass. John, here
five of those barbed wire child gates, thanks.
They're making a movie about my wife's housekeeping. It's called It Came From Beneath the...
In my house, there are many strange things under the bed.
Under the bed.
Thank you.
Okay, Ron, one. Yes, sir, Steve.
You know, whenever I'm in a sloppy mood and I want to file things, I always put it under the carpet.
Under the carpet. Sweep it under the carpet. Well, it's a saying, isn't it? Let's sweep it under the carpet. What have you got, Judy?
It came from beneath the couch.
Couch. All right. So there we are at the end of round one. A good game going here. 3-1 the score. Round two coming up right after this. Okay, here we go to round two. Bing. Lisa, you're ahead. You go first.
B, please.
All right. Three people play. Roxie, Steve, and Judy. Say, you may not know this, but if you get a parking ticket in Iran, the Ayatollah takes your car out and blanks it. All right. Here we go, Lisa. You ready, Judy? You may not know this, but if you get a parking ticket in Iran, the Ayatollah takes your car out and blanks it.
What they do for everything, they shoot it.
They shoot it?
Yeah.
All right. Okay. What do you say, Roxie?
Well, a reasonable facsimile of the same. He bombs it.
Bombs it. Mm. Close. Yeah. Had the same idea, but that doesn't add up to a match here.
I have no match. I just have a brilliant line. Takes your car out and holds it hostage.
Holds it hostage. All right. Oh, my brother. Speaking of holding hostage, what have you got for us?
Holds it hostage.
Aha. Uh-huh. There's two of those.
Speaking of brilliant.
He must have been looking over your shoulder.
You bet he was.
No. All right.
More likely the other way.
All right, Lisa, you didn't pick up any there, and it gives Ron a chance to do a little catching up. Say, did you hear about the nearsighted farmer?
I can never
play nearsighted farmer.
Yes, let me tell you about him. He went to Hollywood and tried to blank Orson Welles.
You know, Gene, I don't do this just everywhere, but today, on this stage, I'm going to grill a cheese sandwich. All right, where were you on the night of the 23rd, or what does Malone mean to you? Fess up, your dirty bunko, drove the getaway loaf. Yeah, you're gonna talk.
Yeah. Okay.
I like this.
I'll just write down any stupid thing just to get off the...
All right, Ron. Did you hear about the nearsighted farmer?
Not yet.
He went to Hollywood, and he tried to blank Orson Welles.
Milk.
Oh. Tried to milk him. You understand the logic of my response. You see, he's nearsighted, and he just saw this large, looming shape, and he mistook it for a cow, and he went up, and
he was a dairy farmer.
Lower.
Yeah.
Thanks.
That he might plant him.
Might have planted him. All right, try to plant him. All right, Bruce.
Well, see, I think that's a very good answer. I originally said eat him, but then I remembered he was a farmer, and.
Plant.
By right gosh, plant. I went with plant.
Plant you down, dig you later.
Yeah. I'm going to take that as a very positive boo.
But before you plant something, you have to irrigate it.
Irrigate.
Don't you?
Right.
Maybe it's after. I don't know.
Well, that's after.
I didn't play, but I said fertilize.
Oh! What do you got for us?
Well, before you said farmer, I thought he might try and pick up. You know, you come to the big city and you try to get a date. But after you said farmer, I went with plant.
All right. Everybody's got that over here, Ron.
That was even better, Boo.
He tried to fertilize him.
Okay. So, the score remains 3-1 at the end of round two. The third and final round will be along right after this. Third and final round coming up. Lisa, you're still ahead. You'll have to go first here.
A, please.
All right. Three people again, Roxie, Steve, and Judy. Betty said, food at that Mexican restaurant is so hot. Was that the fourth grade? Can I hear the whole group now? The food at that Mexican restaurant is so hot. Before you eat it, you have to take out blank insurance. All right. Here we go. Lisa. Betty said the food at that Mexican restaurant is so hot, before you eat it, you have to take out blank insurance.
Fire insurance.
Very good answer. Fire. Hello, Roxie.
Hello, Gene.
Ready?
Set.
Go.
Fire it.
Fire it. All right. A little fire insurance, Steve?
I wish I had so reasonable an answer. Mine is basically a stupid answer. Gas insurance.
Gas insurance.
Go ahead and boo. Boo, I'm booing myself. The worst thing I've ever said with my mouth.
All right. One more chance to pick up another vote here, Lisa, from Judy.
Fire insurance.
Fire. All right. So, Ron, you need 4 to tie, 5 to win. Let's see if it happens. Everyone except John will play here. Beverly Hills is such a ritzy city.
How ritzy is it?
All the bag ladies carry blank. Remember what I said earlier, singular or plural, there's no implication there. You make up your own mind about that. Yes.
Hey, we're just match game. Match game. Squares. Oh.
Got to mix it up. Got to mix it up. Get it down, get down, get down.
That's so Roxy.
Good job now. Help me.
All right.
We're lost. We're the lost tribe.
Here we go.
Everybody.
Beverly Hills is such a ritzy city. All the bag ladies carry blank.
Gucci bags.
Gucci bags. Gucci, Gucci, Gucci.
What designer was that?
Gucci, Gucci bags. Gucci bags. Bags. Thank you. All right, Bruce.
It's really weird you had this question, because I stayed out so late last night that I woke up with bag ladies under my eyes. But I went with Gucci bags.
All right, score is now 5-3. Okay, Steve.
As the senior joke writer on this panel, if I may arbitrarily say, you shouldn't repeat the basic word, so it's Gucci's.
Gucci.
What is Gucci your... bags.
High score.
Gucci bags. Yeah.
Squares. Here comes the rest of our set. We'll bring on three more celebrities. I'll switch places with John. We've got lots more excitement coming along. Don't go away. We'll be right back.
A member of our studio audience will receive Commodore 64 computer featuring 64K memory, full-size keyboard, color graphics, sprite, sound capability, music composer cartridge, and program reference guide furnished by Commodore. It's time for more of the Match Game. Hollywood Squares. Power with from Trapper John, M.D., Brian Mitchell. From Days of Our Lives, Gloria Loring. Jayne Meadows. And taking over the star of the Hollywood Square.
Stay where you are.
And now, John Bauman and the Hollywood Square.
Thank you. Welcome. Welcome once again to Ron Washam.
Going to carry a Gucci bag from now on, aren't you?
At all times. Boy George or anything, I don't care. I'll dress anywhere I can.
I'm very impressed. You're a writer and a waiter, which is clever because it only entails the changing of one letter. Also, three brand new celebrities. Gloria Loring.
Hello.
Brian Mitchell. And Jayne Meadows. Gloria Loring, star of Days of Our Lives, you are also a writer. If not a waiter, you have a new book called Living the Days of Our Lives. What's it about?
It's a sharing on a woman-to-woman basis what I've learned, and I use the makeup and hair and wardrobe people on our show. Plus, it has a chapter I wrote about my life and sort of what I've been through. It's meant to be like a friend talking to a friend about what they know.
Mm-hmm. Terrific. Yeah. Okay, we'll be sure to get a copy, you know. Some beauty tips to go with your nice Gucci purse. Here we go over here to play Hollywood Squares.
And before we begin the game, we will reacquaint ourselves with our defending champ. She's only been here for one day, but it was a pretty productive afternoon for her. Her favorite city is Chicago, Illinois.
Yes, definitely now.
As of yesterday, when she matched and acquired $21,600, her name is Cheryl Cassidy.
Very exciting.
Well, have you figured out how to spend $21,600 yet? Any thoughts in your mind?
Oh, lots of them. I want to spend some on my kids and some on my friends, and I'm going to go to Hawaii this summer.
Cool. We've also gotten several applications since yesterday from people on the panel, celebrity panel, who now want to become contestants. Unfortunately, that is impossible. You have to stay right there and play Hollywood Squares until you hear the Time's Up bell. Whoever's ahead at that point is naturally the winner and can play Super Match for up to $30,000. You won 20 yesterday. First game's worth $100, $25 for every square. Cheryl, your move.
Bruce, please.
Bruce Baum.
Yeah.
You're a tiger. Are your whiskers ornamental? Or do you use your whiskers like curb feelers?
That's exactly how they're used, especially at the night in the jungle when there's a lot of trees around. And they're stalking. No, they are.
And I see you brought your own prop for this as well. Yeah.
I'm propless on this. No, they use them kind of like feelers. Wait, can I change that?
Sure.
No, they don't. It's ornamental. They use it to attract another tiger.
He says the whiskers are just ornamental. Cheryl, agree or disagree?
I'll agree.
Tigers do use their whiskers like curb feelers. Either Bruce should have stuck with his first answer or you should have disagreed, but any way you look at it, your opponent gets the first square, which means there's 1-0 up there already on the board for you, Ron.
I'll go with Gene Rayburn, please.
Gene for another 0. Gene, you're craving a wild goose.
Sure. Every day I wake up and I say, where is my wild goose?
Then a hand reaches up from under the bed.
Right.
Now, according to the Joy of Cooking, not to change the subject, should your wild goose be a young one? Or will an old goose be just as good?
You know what Ben Franklin said, but that doesn't apply here. However, I believe the younger one would be more tender than the older bird. You know, okay. An old bird is tough. Young birds are tender.
So he says the best wild goose is a young goose. Agree or disagree, Ron?
I'll agree.
Yes, your wild goose should, in fact, be young. You are right to agree. Right. You get the square. Gene's reasoning is perfect. An old goose is tough.
Right.
Right. The origin of the expression, tough old goose. Cheryl, your move.
Jayne DeBlock, please.
Mm-hmm. You missed this one. 3-0 for Ron, and he takes the first game. Jayne Meadows.
Yes.
In 1948, a new invention had the code name Madam X. Was it the world's first hydrogen bomb or the 45 RPM record?
Let's see. The hydrogen bomb probably was discovered in 1948. The year I was... Oh, let me... I would say yes. I cannot imagine that name would go with the record player. I bet it was the code name for the hydrogen bomb.
To block, agree or disagree, Cheryl?
I'll agree.
It was the code name for the 45 RPM record. Believe it or not, your opponent, you should have disagreed. Your opponent gets that square. Your opponent wins the first game in a clean sweep. Wow. Could have fooled me. Hydrogen bomb was pretty convincing. But Ron, you got $175. Not up for you so far, Cheryl, but still early. Clear the board. We're going to move on to a $200 game, $25 once again for every square. Cheryl, your move. Pick a star.
Gloria, please.
Gloria Loring.
I am all yours for a moment here.
Just wait till I finish this question, okay?
You'll be right up.
You're taking a walk outside during a tornado.
Oh, what a smart thing to do.
Now, to best protect yourself, should you lie down in a ditch or climb a tree?
I will tell you a very quick funny story about this. I was once in Texas when a tornado hit, and I was on stage doing a show. And I used to close my show with the song Leaving on a Jet Plane. And that was my Baum music, and they'd keep playing Leaving on a Jet Plane as I walked off and said goodnight and everything. And they came just before my closing number and said, there's a tornado coming, everyone to the storm cellar, downstairs, etc. And I said, okay, well, I'll finish the song and then we'll all go. And I finished the song, sang my last note. I said, let's go, and we all started. And I turned around as everyone was leaving, and the musicians were still there playing the Baum music. Don't have any sense at all. You would absolutely not get in a tree. Are they kidding? You'd get in a ditch, my dear.
Lie down in a ditch, she says. Agree or disagree?
I'll agree.
You lie down in a ditch. Yeah. Yes, you're perfectly right to agree. And you get the first square in this game. Gets you off to a good start here. We're going to find out what happens right after these messages. Don't miss it.
Stay tuned for more of The Match Game, Hollywood Squares Hour. Now, back to John Bauman and the Hollywood Square.
All right, thank you. $175 for the challenger, $25 for the champ. That reflects, I think, your state of relaxation. In the commercial break, Ron told me how nice he thought my jacket was. So I see that
it's a Gucci, isn't it?
Thank you very much.
Right at home, Ron. We'll write the jokes. Pick a star.
I'll take Bruce, please.
All right, Bruce Baum. Actually, we don't write any of these jokes. We just make them up. Right, Bruce?
Right here on the spot.
Tom Selleck says that this part of him does not match his 6'4" stature. Is it?
Oh, I get choices. Good. I'm out of trouble that way.
Is it his voice or his feet?
Okay, in keeping with giving logic to these answers, I'm going to go with his voice because I think he may think his voice is a little bit high, and I assume he's got normal-sized feet because he plays volleyball. And if you have small feet and you play volleyball, you're liable to tip over instead.
Agree or disagree that Tom Selleck's voice does not match his 6'4" stature?
I agree.
In Tom's opinion.
I agree.
It is his voice. Yes, you're right to agree. You get the square. So an X and an O are up there in the $200 game. And Cheryl Cassidy, your move.
Gene, please.
Gene Rayburn.
Right.
Yes. I've gotten confused between Gene and Jayne before. Gene Rayburn, you want your cat to stop killing birds.
Yes.
According to the Old Farmer's Almanac, you should tie something around its neck for several days. Is it a small sack of garlic or a dead bird?
Yes.
Or a yellow picture of Tony Orlando.
Well, now, garlic.
Or a dead bird.
Garlic would certainly not scare other birds away, would it? No.
Works on vampires, though.
That's right.
They're bats.
Garlic would only scare people away, have nothing to do with birds. Birds wouldn't smell of garlic, would they? No, they wouldn't smell of garlic.
Well, you want your cat to stop killing birds.
Yeah.
So you're going to tie this around your cat's neck.
A dead bird or a clove of garlic?
Right.
A clove of garlic makes no sense to me whatsoever.
Okay.
And neither does the other one. So what the... Give me the third one, John.
Pick an answer anyway.
All right. Okay, I'll say garlic. What a dumb question. A dumb question.
He says that a small sack of garlic should be tied around your cat's neck to stop it from killing birds. Agree or disagree, Cheryl?
Oh, this is just a stab in the dark.
That's right. You tie a bell around the cat's neck. These two answers make
I'll agree with him.
In order to stop your cat from killing birds, you should tie a dead bird around its neck, which makes some sense. I can't editorialize, but I think that makes some sense because...
Where are you going to get a dead bird, dummy?
Well, not
you
feed him garlic.
Look, a dead bird.
You got to kill a bird to get it. That's terrible.
What are you doing with your...
Ron, your move. You've got two O's up there.
I'll take a Jayne to win, please.
Jayne Meadows for a game win and a bigger lead. As a man reaches his twilight years, Jayne, does his brain shrink? Can you keep these intimacies with your husband down to a minimum?
No. Can't resist.
As a man reaches his twilight years, does his brain shrink or does the size of his brain remain the same?
Does our brain shrink or remain the same?
They already said that.
I think
it's a man, not a woman, Jayne.
You're a doctor.
I don't know. I'm not in my twilight years, though.
I think our brains remain the same.
Okay. And that goes for a man as well.
I think
so. The brains in Spain remain the same.
I think it's the same for men and women.
Only when you're on the plane.
It's the same for men and women. Yes.
What I have garnered from all of this is that Jayne says that as a man reaches his twilight years, the size of his brain remains the same.
Yes,
agree or disagree for another game, Ron?
I agree.
As a man reaches his twilight years, a man's brain shrinks. You should have disagreed with Jayne. Your opponent gets that square and blocks you
and
there.
What about women's brains?
So, another question
We're
entirely.
We're still doing experiments on that.
The squares are on the other foot. Cheryl, it's your move.
Not meant to jam.
Brian, please.
Brian Mitchell for a game win for Cheryl.
Yes, put the pressure on, John.
Brian, according to the 1936 edition of Vogue's Book of Etiquette, Is it okay for a gentleman to put his arm around the back of his lady's theater seat? Or is that a gauche public display of affection?
Back of his theater's her
his lady's theater seat. 1936 edition of Vogue.
Code word for something or what? Theater seat? Is it 36? Back of the lady's theater seat. Is that okay to do it?
Yes.
I don't understand that question.
He loves her seat.
Right. It's 1936. Pretend it's 1936.
You mean like this old? That old trick.
Right. That's right.
According to Vogue's book of etiquette. 1936. No, they were more conservative back there. That's gauche. That's gauche.
He says it's gauche. A gauche display of public. Public display of affection, Cheryl, agree or disagree?
I'll agree.
The game. It is a gauche display of affection. You're right to agree. That is not a gauche answer. You get the square and you win the game. All right. Congratulations.
Thank you.
What that means to all of our collective lives is that we've got a real barn burner going. 275 to 225. We're going to be back to decide this after these messages. 275, 225, $300 game. Ron, you start.
I'll start with Bruce, please.
Okay. Bruce Baum, does a cucumber have a gender?
It looks like it.
Or is it a sexless vegetable?
I think a cucumber is a gender. Yeah. I'm gonna go being a. It's a fruit, isn't it? It's not a vegetable because the seeds are on the.
You're getting a little confused now, Bruce.
No, I was talking scientific there. No, I mean the seeds are on the inside, so that makes it a fruit. And I don't think there's male and female fruits. I say that with all due respect.
Bruce,
do you have an answer on your agenda, Bruce?
You never realized you could be so funny without even trying, did you?
I'm going to say it's a sexless
vegetable.
Or fruit. I think it's a fruit.
He says
the seeds are on the inside.
When I say vegetable, Bruce says vegetable. He says it's a sexless vegetable. Agree or disagree, Ron?
I agree.
A cucumber has a gender. Cucumbers are female.
Oh.
I don't know.
Wait,
ask your local greengrocer or a cucumber sex therapist. Cheryl, pick a star.
Carefully. Jayne, please.
Okay.
Is that like the only
Jayne Meadows.
The breeze
Jayne
by mitosis?
Meadows? Okay.
Jayne Meadows for an X.
Yes.
You're hosting your own birthday party, Jayne, and you're only six. According to Amy Vanderbilt's everyday etiquette, if you win a prize at the party, can you keep it? Or is that bad manners?
I'm giving the party.
You are giving the party.
If I win a prize in party.
Right. It also says you're 6 years old. I don't know.
Oh, 6 years old. I thought you meant six guests. If you're 6 years old, I would think you could. At 6 years old, wouldn't you think so?
You can keep it.
Of course.
Agree or disagree, Cheryl?
I'll agree.
If you're 6 years old, I don't know if this applies to every age, according to Amy Vanderbilt's everyday etiquette, it is still bad manners to keep your own.
She's
okay, keep the prize. All right, your opponent gets that square. So let's keep it moving because we got a very tight game here. Ron, you're playing you got one up there. Pick a star.
I'll go with Gloria, please.
Gloria Loring.
Yes.
You have insects in your pee patch.
How rude.
What should you plant in your garden to keep them out? Garlic or marigolds?
I have insects in my pea patch. Please don't spread it around. Garlic, I know you can use garlic and you can spray it. Garlic and onions, and you can make a solution and spray it on things, but planting it, you don't smell it. Marigolds are awful smelling things when they grow and not particularly attractive either. So I'm going to go with marigolds, definitely.
She says you should put marigolds to get those insects out of your pea patch. Agree or disagree, Ron?
I agree.
Marigolds will apparently get those insects out of your pea patch. Well done. You get another O. So, 300 to 275, a $25 difference, but this game is pivotal. Cheryl, pick a star.
Brian to block, please.
You missed this one, the game, and the lead goes to Ron. Brian Mitchell.
Yes,
once
sir.
Again, for a game, for a critical question.
Yes.
You're shopping for a duck, Brian.
Yes.
According to the joy of international cooking, should you look for one with a nice pair of legs or one with a broad, meaty breast?
Well, I guess it depends on what you want to do with it. Broad, meaty breast, or a pair of nice legs.
I would say, I would, for if you're going to eat it, you're not going to eat the legs, right? You're going to eat the breast.
Says you should look for a duck with a broad, meaty breast. To block, Cheryl, agree or disagree?
Oh, boy. I'm going to disagree.
Wrong.
Unpopular answer, and for a good reason. You should look with a duck with a... with a broad, meaty breast. Oh. Yo, you should have agreed with Brian. Your opponent gets that square and wins yet another game. Annabelle means that time is up. He has done it. That question, everything wrote on it. $600, new champion Ron Washam. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Attaboy.
Congratulations. Woo!
That was about as tight as it gets. Ron has run over to join Gene Rayburn, gets set for a shot at the big money. It always does come down to one question somewhere along the line.
Right.
Not usually as dramatically as in this last game. You had a very productive day yesterday, however.
Yes.
Your grand total
Wonderful.
For your 2 days here, $21,900. Not too bad for Cheryl Cassidy. Congratulations. Gene Rayburn, take it.
Okay, John, here we are with the champ. We'll be back with him, Ron, and our stars for a go at the big money, $30,000, right after this.
And now, here to play the super match is Gene Rayburn.
Thank you, Gene Wood. Here we are. Okay, Ron, ready?
I'm ready, Gene.
This is his first time for a go at the big 3-0-0-0-0. Good luck to you, Ron. Yes, sir. A lot of zeros there for that money. We polled a studio audience not too long ago and said, write down your best answer to this. Spare blank. If you give us the most popular answer, it's $1,000. $500 for the second most popular, $250 for the third. Any three of the nine stars can offer a little assistance here.
I'll take John.
Spare tire.
Gloria?
Well, it's my second choice, but I'll say spare parts.
And, well, Jayne?
Spare ribs.
Spare ribs. So those are the three you have. Spare tires, spare parts, spare ribs. Choose one of those, or perhaps you have a better idea in your own cranium.
Well, first thing I thought of was spare tire.
Okay. Spare tires, you want anything we ought to go with. All right. His judgment says the spare tire is going to be on top, but we'll begin at the bottom and reveal first the $250 response. Spare ribs. There's Jane's answer. All right. The $500 response says, spare me.
Oh, yeah, spare me.
What were you doing?
A lot
that
of pleading
crowd?
Was going on that day. I guess they were going to Shanghai the audience or something. Okay, here's your last chance for a spare tire. Slide the big one, Steve. Spare tire. Yeah. You got your $1,000. Oh, atta boy. Now.
Here it is. It's coming.
Now you've got the $1,000. Now it's time for the head-to-head match with any star of your choosing. After you've made your decision, that star will reveal the hidden number. And we'll multiply the $1,000 by whatever number is revealed at that time. It'll be a 10, a 20, or a 30. So whatever number is revealed, you're going to play for 10,000, 20,000, or 30,000. None of them is a shabby number.
Not at all. I'll go with John again.
All right, John. We want to see what your hidden number is. Ready, set, go. $20,000. $20,000. Very good, Ron. Here we go. Liquor blank. That's L-I-Q-U-O-R. Liquor blank. John is ready, Ron. And there's your $20,000. Doesn't it look big? Oh, that's a lot of money. Ooh. What do you say to collect the $20,000? Liquor
liquor license.
The audience is not too thrilled with that, are they? Well, let's find out if John liked it. That's the important thing. If he says liquor license, you get the money. If he doesn't, you don't. And we beat up on you later, too. All right, John, go.
Well, I guess there are a lot of better answers to this question, but I didn't think of any of them. Liquor license.
$600. Congratulations to you, Ron. And we'll be back with Ron and the Stars right after this. Okay, here we go. We're going to find out where the big 3-0 is right here. And now, Stars, would you all grab the tab? Ready, set, go. Steven
one seat over. Had it. 28, okay. Dad.
We'll see you tomorrow, Stars. Thank you. Gene Rayburn inviting you to join us tomorrow.
John Bauman saying so long for the Match Game Hollywood Squares arrow. Let's go have a drink.
A member of our studio audience will receive the KitchenAid food processor. Chops, minces, mixes, slices, and shreds. A versatile appliance with power and speed. Practical with quality. Furnished by KitchenAid. This is Gene Woods speaking for the Match Game, Hollywood Squares Hour. A Mark Goodson Television Production.